I'm gonna let you in on a little bit of a secret about me. Something that you might not know about me just by looking at me and observing what's going on here on this YouTube channel. And that secret is, I hate local crime stories. I hate all of them. I think they're ridiculous, and I hate the idea that we can take a local crime story and blow it up into a national issue and pretend that this one case is representative of the nation as a whole, when it rarely is. In fact, it's typically the opposite of representative of the nation as a whole. But even worse than a local crime story, which I cannot stand, a case that the nation all follows for some odd reason, like Casey Anthony, is the local non-crime story that for some reason, for some ungodly purpose, grips the entire nation. And the case and point that I will be talking about today, if you haven't seen the title of this video, if you haven't looked into the thumbnail, is the Amy Cooper case. The case of Amy Cooper not committing a crime against Christian Cooper.
I'm sorry, I'm in a ramble, and there is a man, African-American, who has a bicycle helmet. He is recording me and threatening me and my dog. There is an African-American man, I am in Central Park, he is recording me and threatening myself and my dog. I'm sorry, I can't hear you either. I'm being threatened by a man into the ramble. Please send the cops immediately. I'm in Central Park in the ramble. I don't know.
Thank you.
Recently, it was reported that Amy Cooper, who's been dubbed by the media and racists on the internet as Central Park Karen, will not be charged criminally any further after she completed 5 classes of racial diversity training. Now, if you'll remember, Amy Cooper was the woman in the viral video committing the non-crime of calling the police on a black person who was vaguely threatening and intimidating her in Central Park. Now, you don't have to take my word for it. You don't have to believe what I'm saying. You can actually take it straight from the horse's mouth, and that is the alleged victim in this case, Christian Cooper, who, according to himself, was implying that he was going to take this woman's dog because she was letting her dog walk through the park without a leash, and this bothered him. In fact, this bothered him so much that he actually carried dog treats on him for such an instance. I believe his exact quote was, "Okay, if you want to do whatever you want to do, I'm going to do whatever I want to do, and I'm certain that you will not like it." Now, in response to this man approaching her in the park, luring her dog close to him, Amy ends up calling the police. Now, you might be upset that Amy called the police, and as somebody who's had the police called on me multiple times for what I believe to be frivolous reasons as I was growing up, I can empathize with Christian Cooper in this situation. However, you have to think about this logically for just a split second before you jump on board this viral video craze. If you, any man in this audience, were to go to a park with dog treats, approach a woman who is alone in the park with her dog, and then hold out those treats to lure the dog to you while vaguely threatening that woman, would you expect the police to be called on you? The answer to that question is obviously yes. If you, a man of any race, approach a woman in a park alone, you start lecturing her about her violating the rules of the park, and when she doesn't respond the way that you want, you start pulling out treats and implying that you're going to take her dog as punishment for her not following your orders, you can expect to get the police called on you, especially here in the United States of America, where people are outrageously in love with your dogs. You know me, I am a known dog mom hater, but I actually acknowledge the fact that dog moms exist and they would freak out completely. This is something that I pointed out on this channel multiple times, especially when people like Anna Kasparian, who calls herself a dog mom, lecture this woman for being a racist, when in that exact same scenario, Anna Kasparian would have acted in the exact same way, if not worse, because Anna Kasparian is a terrible person. However, this wasn't the story. The story wasn't two people argued, then the police were called. It was kind of an annoying situation of two people getting on each other's nerves in the park of New York City. It was racist attack, historically racist. This woman was trying to get this man killed for daring to approach her. Here's a black and white photo of a black man and a dog from the 1960s. Look at how racist that is. This woman is racist. She needs to be arrested. The mayor commented on it, and it became a national news story for now about 9 months in this country. 9 months of talking about this non-crime in this nation that is easily explainable once you take the person who filmed the video's side of the story into its full context. This is somehow breaking news in this nation. This is somehow something that led to criminal charges. This is somehow something that pressured legislatures across the country to consider laws like the Karen Act, even though nobody committed a crime in this scenario. And I understand fully why both people acted the way that they did in this scenario. One person was videotaping this to post this on the internet because he thought it was hilarious, and the other person felt scared because she was approached by a dude in a park who was basically implying that he was going to take her dog as punishment. I mean, honestly, think about how much coverage this story has gotten. This story of a non-crime, this story of an argument between two people in New York City as compared to other stories. I actually tuned in to Philip DeFranco's show the other day, and this was the leading segment on his show. The leading segment. And in fact, he was actually upset or seemed upset and wanted to get the opinion of the audience that Amy Cooper wasn't facing criminal charges for the non-crime that she didn't actually commit.
The first thing we're going to talk about today is this news around Amy Cooper, or as probably most of the internet knows her, Central Park Karen. Right? She's that white woman who called 911 on a black man who was birdwatching in the park after he asked her to leash her dog last May.
The Young Turks, one of my absolute favorite channels to make fun of on this channel, has covered the Amy Cooper or Central Park Karen story relentlessly on their channel. This story, again, of a non-crime, has consumed constant airtime on TYT, and if you think it's because they're concerned with local crime in the city of New York, you're absolutely mistaken, because I could give you dozens of stories that could cut the other direction that are actually criminal and far more serious that have no coverage whatsoever on the Young Turks platform because they don't care about it. The reason people are covering this is because it was a white person arguing with a black person, and this can forward their narrative of systemic, institutional, structural, systematic, systemic racism. Around the same time that this 911 call that shocked the conscience of this nation, this 911 call that resulted in no negative consequences whatsoever for Christian Cooper, and actually resulted in only negative consequences for Amy Cooper, who felt threatened in the situation and acted exactly how every single dog mom would have reacted in that exact same scenario, there was a murder in New York City about 15 minutes uptown near Columbia University of Tessa Majors. Tessa Majors was murdered by three 13 to 14 year olds who attempted to rob her and then stabbed her viciously in the street, leaving her to die. She crawled to a security booth at her university to seek help, but unfortunately the security guard was out on patrol and thus she ended up dying on the floor there. This scene was so bloody, by the way, that the police were able to locate where in general the suspects actually lived because they followed the blood trail of Tessa Majors to the Grand Houses near Amsterdam Avenue. But this didn't get anywhere near the same attention as the non-crime story involving Amy Cooper and Christian Cooper, and this was because Tessa Majors looks like this, and the suspects, the 13 and 14-year-olds involved in the case, this is a picture of at least one of them. Now look, to be clear, I'm not saying that the Tessa Majors story should be a racialized national news story. What I am saying is if the races were reversed in that story, and one of the white teenagers that ended up killing a black college student who got herself into a good university as viciously as Tessa Majors was killed, was sentenced to only 18 months, it would be a national news story. And if you're not admitting that, if you're not acknowledging that distinction, then you're totally wrong. And if the races were reversed in the Amy Cooper story, the only way that that would be a national news story was to condemn Christian Cooper, who in this instance would be a white male, for daring to threaten or vaguely threaten a black woman for not having her dog on a leash in Central Park. We would have heard nonstop about how birdwatching is a white privilege and how he tried to exercise his white privilege over this liberated black woman, and he was so repressive, aggressive, and racist, and we need to condemn him fully and get him fired from his job. And it's not like we haven't seen this happen before. Remember the Jasmine Barnes story, which was gaining national attention? Sean King was promoting it, the Young Turks were putting out multiple videos tying the murder of this 7-year-old girl to Donald Trump for some insane reason.
And so this is terrorism. And we don't know why he did it, but it's not related to anything else. It's just not involved in anything. It bothers me that I have to think about it and she has to think about it, and we all have to think about, did she do something wrong? She didn't, right? Obviously, it's relevant, because if there was an earlier dispute, that would explain why it happened, right? But there is no earlier dispute. There was no dispute on the highway. There was no dispute before that. They don't know each other. And look, we don't know what's in the guy's head. He was wearing a red sweatshirt, not a red hat, okay?
Remember, when it was discovered that the murderer of Jasmine Barnes was not a white man and was actually two different black dudes, the case was completely dropped from the national consciousness. All of a sudden, the Young Turks and Sean King washed their hands of it and didn't give you any further updates on it. And in fact, if you Google Jasmine Barnes to find any new information on the trial of the two people that are actually responsible for her case, it completely dead ends after the point where they figured out that it wasn't a white guy. In fact, one of the very few updates to the Jasmine Barnes story that I was able to find after it was discovered that it was two black dudes that ended up killing her was that the guy that Sean King accused of being the killer of Jasmine Barnes, this white guy that he called a racist to his million followers on Twitter, was harassed to the point where he ended up killing himself months later, because even after it was discovered that it was two black guys behind this murder, that didn't stop Sean King's followers from harassing him and his family and his 7-year-old niece, who is the same age as Jasmine Barnes, threatening to murder her for revenge for Jasmine Barnes. Other than that, we haven't heard anything related to the case. Now again, these are all local stories. I don't expect them to get national attention. But you can clearly see that there is a demand in the media for stories that convey a certain narrative. And even when there isn't enough supply to meet that demand, they manufacture things like arguments in Central Park and inflate them, blow them up, in order to be way bigger than they actually are. And I think it's important to acknowledge that what's being shoved in your face is not the most relevant, interesting, or even the most tragic news. That you could blow up any one of these cases to try to make an overall narrative, and that will actually be more accurate in comparison to, again, people arguing over a leash in the middle of Central Park. But hey, those are just my thoughts, and maybe you think I'm wrong. Maybe you think that this argument in Central Park is something that should shock the nation and take up national news coverage for over 9 months, while all these other crimes that are actually crimes should be relegated to local coverage that we don't even talk about and you don't really know unless you happen to live in the same region that the crime occurred. If you think that, let me know your wrong opinion down in the comments below. If you like this video, then show me by leaving a like. You can subscribe for more content. Follow me on all my social medias. They are linked in the description of this video. This has been me talking about the Amy Cooper story, which is, again, a non-story. Till next time.